Hi, I'm Pat Dorsey, Director of Equity Research at Morningstar. With the health care bill, it seems, finally out there and becoming law, and Social Security reform possibly on the table, we've seen a few news reports on that, I thought it might be time to kind of pull back and take an 80,000-foot view of things and look at some demographic issues in terms of how much older the U.S. is getting, and importantly, though, how much older the rest of the world is getting at a faster pace than us. So if you look at just the U.S., the numbers are a little bit scary. There's a ratio called the dependency ratio, which is basically the number of dependents, folks under 15, over 65, per 100 working age individuals. Now, for the purposes of thinking about supporting older individuals, which is more expensive than supporting young folks, and it also gets more expensive over time, because as life expectancies go up, medical treatments cost more and more. The cost of formula doesn't really change over long periods of time. The cost of healthcare does. So it's really that number of older people, number of over 65s per 100 working age individuals that we want to pay attention to. You know, in the U.S. right now, this is about 19. We have about 19 individuals over 65 per 100 people between the ages of 15 and 65 per working age adults. And over the next 40 years, that's going to go to about 35 folks over 65 per 100 working adults. Now, that sounds pretty scary. And indeed, it's a pretty rapid increase in the number of folks needing more medical care, fewer of them working, that the working age population will need to support. The silver lining is the rest of the world has it much worse. If you look at the numbers in, say, Japan, Germany, France, many other parts of the world, these trends are there in spades. In Japan, right now, you have 35 over 65s, and that's going to 75 per 100 working adults over the next 40 years. Germany, almost as bad. Currently 30 over 65s per 100 working adults, going to 59, and France 26 going to 47. Now again, people are working longer as we move more and more to a knowledge-based economy. It's feasible for people to be productive later in life in a way that it wasn't when work consisted of toiling in the fields or working in a steel mill. But the thing to remember is that net-net, more folks in that over 65 bucket relative to other countries, say, Western Europe relative to the U.S., means the U.S. has, frankly, more productive people being used per capita. And so our GDP growth is probably going to be significantly higher because we have more, we have fewer folks in the over 65 area to support. So it's a fascinating thing to think about because in a lot of ways, these are the countries we're competing with right now. Certainly over longer periods of time, as countries like Brazil and Indonesia and India move further up the economic value chain and are able to export and compete in more advanced markets with the US and German and Japanese goods, they will be our competitors as well. But right now, our major competitors for complex manufactured goods on a global market really are these other Western European nations as well as Japan. And frankly, they're going to have a harder and harder time doing it because they don't have this demographic tailwind that the U.S. has. And when you really break things down, there's only two elements really to GDP growth. How many people you got and how productive are they? Population growth and productivity growth. So unless there are massive changes in, say, birth rates in the world, and those tend to be pretty stable over time, the U.S. just has culturally had a higher birth rate than many other countries, or immigration rates. And the U.S. has historically been very immigration friendly relative to many other countries in the world. Well, over a very long haul, it puts us on firmer footing, perhaps, than our industrialized competitors. I'm Pat Dorsey, and thanks for watching.
At Morningstar, we feel it is important to schedule regular checkups of your investments. This is the reason we're pleased to announce Portfolio Monitor, a new and easier way to keep track of your investments. With a few clicks of the mouse, receive a monthly report that provides a comprehensive and customized summary of your portfolio, sent automatically to your inbox. Portfolio Monitor provides a concise digest of all the best features of premium membership. Become a premium member with our 14-day free trial to start receiving Portfolio Monitor today.